So I'd like to talk about this concept, what I'm calling summarizing values of one layer using zones of another layer, which is a zonal operation. And Edrisi implements this with the tool extract, and we'll look at a way to implement this with a tool in ArcGIS in a couple weeks. So in words, what we're doing is we're using the zones of one layer to summarize the values of essentially a second layer. And what we get as an output are basically the zones of the first layer with the kind of summarized values of the second layer. And in the GUIs of GIS, the language can be a little bit maybe harsh, like this is going to ask for kind of a feature definition file. Is that, can you guys read that, or should I try to do this? And then this one is going to be called the image to be processed. And then this is just going to be your output, which you can name something friendly if you want. But for some reason, I think when I started using Edrisi, I found these hard to remember. It was hard for me to remember that this matched this. So my kind of solution is just to kind of make up easier kind of words. And so for me, I just always thought of this as the cookie cutter, and this as the cookie dough. And then the output is just, I can name it anything. So this may give you a language that's a little bit easier to kind of use and think about when you're deciding essentially how to interpret this language. What I tend to do is just when I see image to be processed, I just think, okay, cookie dough. And that means the layer that has the values that I want to summarize. And if it doesn't work for you, it doesn't work for you. But sometimes it's nice to have this kind of more friendly intermediary language between the technical language that the engineers kind of basically wrote when they made the GUIs and the kind of conceptual language that comes from Dana Tomlin and other kind of, I don't want to call them grandfathers, but they are kind of the grandfathers of GIS. So if we take this to be our cookie cutter, the simple 4x4 raster where we have three zones, right? A black zone, this yellow zone, and this green zone. And I'm going to go ahead and put in numbers here. So I'm going to use 0 to represent the values for the black zone because it's kind of like our background zone that we're getting used to. Did I get that right? Let's see. Missed one. And then I'll use 1 for the yellow zone. And then I'll use 2 for the green zone. And so if this is our cookie cutter, the next thing we'll need is a simple case for the cookie dough. So let's start with another one, another simple raster. And I'm just going to do, well, it depends on, sorry, I'm going to put a 0 there. I'm going to put 1s here. I'll put 2s like that, and then 3s. and fours, fives, and six there. So this could be a bunch of numbers if you want to look at it that way. It could be kind of striped agricultural fields if you want to look at it that way. It could be a slope if you want to look at it like elevation, kind of starting here and kind of slanting down. So it could be anything, but the point is that it's our cookie dough, most importantly. And so what we'd like to do is basically use our zones and summarize essentially this data based on our zones. And so let me see, I have an output, and let's do this output as, first, let's call this the minimum. So I'm going to say, all right, this guy, I want to be the minimum. And so what that means is, let's start with the yellow one. If I took the yellow one off, I'm basically now just looking at this subset of the cookie dough. And what's the minimum value? And so what do I do with that minimum value? Well, I basically replicate the shape in the output, right? So I've now taken the shape of the zone, but filled it with the value, the minimum value of the cookie dough. So that's cool. Now let me do green. Okay, so what's the minimum value of this? So far so good. So now let me just do the minimum value of black, and it's 0. So all the locations of what was the black zone get filled with the minimum value that lies underneath that zone in the image to be processed, right? Does that make sense? So what if we did it for max, starting with yellow? What should be my maximum value here? Now everything would get 3, right? Sorry. And I just want to remind myself that this is the max. And so what would be for the green? Everything would get 6. And then what would be the result for the black? Everything would get 5. Fair enough. So that's essentially, let me see if I can move this one over. There's the max. There's the min. And it came from essentially this cookie dough that was kind of cut up by this, by these cookie cutters, right? Does that look pretty good? I'll just kind of maybe take the colors off, and this is essentially our work. Sorry for that little mess up there, but that should be a 1, correct?